Hello everyone, as we all have been going through some challenging situations during these recent times, one such challenge is how to handle grief. So we, the counselors from the Student Wellness Center co-counseling team, on the occasion of World Mental Health Day, are here to suggest ways to deal with grief. I would like to thank Tagare ma'am and Hima ma'am for giving us the opportunity to reach out to you. Before we understand how to deal with grief, we would like you to understand what is grief. Let's look at some situations that we have heard or faced in our lives. Feeling lost after the loss of a loved one, losing your life partner, someone who is a dear friend to you has ended their life, parents have had a divorce, or losing a job or an internship. Struggling with a difficult breakup. So here we see grief is an emotional experience, a response or reaction to any form of loss. Grief involves so many feelings and all are normal. It is often possible that we find it difficult to identify emotions in grief. It is tough to know what one is feeling. There's also something known as bereavement. It's a type of grief involving loss of a loved one. An individual experiences a range of difficult emotions. This experience differs from person to person. While speaking or thinking of these life situations, I'm sure we all feel pushed to an uncomfortable space in our hearts. Grief is that sense of the loss we feel due to these changes in life. Sometimes, we feel confused and think nothing makes sense. As mentioned by a licensed psychologist, during these pandemic times, grief has been a complex process. The additional personal losses, as well as constantly hearing about the losses of others, some of us do not understand how to handle it. And what needs to be done and what is to let go. Let's also look at some myths of grief. The first one that we're going to discuss about is guilt and grief. People often blame themselves or they feel guilty when a loved one passes away. Here it is vital to understand that without having something to blame, we need to accept that situations are unpredictable and beyond control. While we need to also keep in mind that self-blame is a coping mechanism that some use when processing the grief that they are experiencing. In these times, due to the pandemic, research has shown people who suffered the COVID-19 virus and lost a loved one may be experiencing survivor's guilt, where they survived and others in their family didn't. In such situations, avoid making what-if statements surrounding the now deceased person. For example, in some situation, what if I had known earlier that something worse would happen? We would have avoided this tragedy in our lives. Such situations bring about a resistance within us, and this can in turn lead to shame, along with the uncontrollable loss, and thus make the loss more harder to handle. No one can control when it happens, nor understand why it happens. The second type of myth that we have all known is ignoring the pain while in grief. Grief is hard. We often think to run away from it. No matter how much you try to run away, grief will always find you. Grief is a lifelong process. So no matter how painful and worse it feels, allow yourself to experience it. This will help you to map your way to heal. Another type of myth that we have heard about is the pace of dealing with grief, or this should be faster for me as it was for my friend. Let's remember, there is no fixed method to feel grief when faced with the death of a loved one or a friend. So if you have any friend or any close person to suggest to you how you should feel, this is not right, as no two journeys can be the same. There is no right or wrong way to experience grief. You are capable of overcoming this shame and uncover your thoughts with small moments of appreciation by doing one thing at a time. For you to feel better will be of great help.
Now let's talk about process of coping with grief. Everyone heals differently. There are different ways every individual cope with grief. Dr. Lewis Tompkins' theory suggests that the grief remains same, but your life begins to grow around it. That means one can grieve the loss of their loved ones and also carry out the daily routine activities. Connecting with the people around, share feeling that may be helpful. If required, seeking help from the mental health professional can be recommended. While going through a grief or a loss, emotional regulation can be an important part of coping process. Dysfunctional emotions largely derive from the different interpretations of a situation or an event. Sometimes we tend to believe every thought we engage in, and which can be really overwhelming. Learning skills to understand and name your emotions and working towards reducing the frequency and intensity of unhealthy emotions is a part of emotional regulation. What can be helpful is creating a support system, learning skills to calm yourself, using creative ways to cope with distress like journaling, expressing thoughts through any kind of art form. Developing tolerance is a skill building towards acceptance. When we are grieving, we cannot change the circumstances. We cannot undo the loss, and we cannot take away the painful emotional experiences. Accepting the situation, accepting the loss and intense pain is largely within our control. This eventually helps us in growing life around the experience of a grief. Strength in grief can be accepting and expressing your feelings.